Our coach today is Marty Rowland from KBV Singletail Start at Murphy Creek, Queensland. And our first class grading for our judge is class 278, heifer 8 months. For those of you tracking your catalogues, we've got two scratches in this class. There's the first one, which I suppose is 701, there's no number there in the catalogue, and catalogue number 702 is also another scratch. welcome, ladies and gentlemen. We have the results now of our first class in the junior heifers for Murray Grey Ring. Class 278 heifer, 8 months and under 12 months. Third place goes to the boys in this partnership. And third place goes to catalog number 707, Regilla Park Penny, exhibited by Graham and Barbara Hutchins. I'd like to call our judge, Marty Rollins, to comment on the first of our female classes.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. And, first of all, I'd like to take this opportunity to sincerely thank the RAS and the Murray Grey Breed Society for entrusting my comments for today and entrusting the place in the county and the order for which I see. The female that I brought up to that shoulder is just a lovely, lovely. She walked out particularly well. If there's anything perhaps I'd like to just read through a little bit in the pin. So when you're looking at her, an interesting female, probably hasn't had a female good and clean. Congratulations to the good old Touching Up. The female I got in second place is an interesting female, and I think that we need to take note of a female like this. I think the scale of this female is admirable. She probably didn't handle those back legs quite as well today. She's probably just not a little shy on the halter, which is making her spin one leg. But, you know, you've got to admire the softness in this female and the sheer power performance by still maintaining that femininity. She's a lovely female as well, just giving away a little bit away in that strength as fine, which has put her in second place. The female in third place, again, a very interesting female, but when it comes down to the crunch, we look at structural correctness, and we want to keep these females in our herd for a very long time. You've got to admire the hoof shape and the structure of this female, probably giving a little bit away in strength and spine, and particularly through that rear end, but again, three very good exhibits. It's a shame there's only one exhibit in this class, but you've got to admire the performance in this female. There's certainly the ability to cover, and she's got to be admired for that. I'll retain the rest of my comments for the championship, and a very good exhibit.
281. Murray Grey Heifer, 16 months and under 18 months. First place goes to catalog number 719. Bruna Park, that's the comment.
I went through an area that had Murray Grey cows on both sides of the road, and the scale and depth and altitude in her, but still maintaining that femininity that I'm looking for. There's a lot of longevity in the female. I think that she's outstanding. So the depth of body, the shape of her rib is outstanding. That rip through that hard water, she's an outstanding exhibit. The female in second place, outdone on the day by the sheer power and performance of that other female. But again, we're maintaining our femininity. She's good through that high quarter. She just didn't handle her feet and legs just as well as that female that I've got in first place. But you've got to mind the softness in this female, the shape of her rib. Yeah, she's outstanding. And it's just a shame she's come up against such an outstanding female. But congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're now on to the Triple Mark 282. Murray Grey Heifer, 18 months and under 20 months.
There are two interesting females. The female that I've got up on top here today, look, it's quite evident that she was probably going into the girl in second place. But look, the smoothness of the shoulder, the length of body, the squareness through the hind quarter, and that impeccable structure is what's got this female up on top. She's got a little bit extra neck extension, she's got a little bit extra length of body, and take nothing away from the female I've got in second on as far as hoof stock is concerned. But again, we're taking things right down to the team here, and she's probably a little bit on the heavier side, if I can say, but probably showing a little bit of hoof structure. But the female that I have on top, it's very easy to win on the day. Thanks very much, Marty, for those comments. Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to
at the second place getters of those previous heifer classes. Grey heifer for the 2018 Royal Queensland Show is catalogue number 719, Bruna Park Sapphire, exhibited by GG and SA Taylor. And our reserve junior champion is catalogue number 711, Kalinga Sixpence, exhibited by Kim Carlton. Roger McGray.
There's always going to be out of these two females. Female is female. You know, she's a big heifer, no doubt. But you know, when we're looking at the length of body and the strength of spine in this female is not dissimilar to the one we have got in second place. And again, just so smooth through that shoulder and lovely through that rear. She's a lovely heifer. The female miss all day and talk about the structure of these cattle, and it's something that I'll be taking a particular eye on. But you know, you've got to have a balance of the power performance along with your fertility and your femininity. And you look at the two females I've got on top, and that balance is perfect. The other one that this female's outstanding, the strength is fine and the femininity. She's certainly the sort of female that we try to breed at home.
Class 200 have been scratched. Behind the pace per 100 square centimetres. And catalogue number 729 weighs 526 kilograms. Average daily gain of 1.41. Fat measurements of 5 and 4. And an eye muscle area of 97 square centimetres.
But again, it's that it's an overall performance in this calf which has placed him over the bull that I've individual her.
Ladies and gentlemen, the results now class 285 for 14 months and under 16 months. First place goes to catalogue number 733, Red Gum Nightcap, led by Red Gum Murray Grays. And second place goes to catalogue number 734, Gagara No Name, led by Terry Leary. I'd like to call on our judge to comment on this class.
Yeah, we've got two bulls here, a similar style, similar capacity, and certainly similar performance. The bull that I've drawn with on top, just probably a little bit better skin type as opposed to the bull that I've got in second place. Again, we're admiring the side appeal of this first guy. The great hooded eye and the length of body, that develops into an adequate hind quarter and an adequate rear quarter. So a little bit extra depth of body in the bull that plays him over the guy that I've got in second. You know, you've really got to look at this guy and admire him for his performance as with the first guy. But again, probably just giving a little bit away in front of the reference from on, but two pretty good. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I
Ladies and gentlemen, that brings us now to class 286, Murray Gray Ball, 16 months and under 18 months. Providing demonstration for our judge, catalogue number 735, weighs 826 kilograms, average daily gain of 1.59, fascination of 12% and an eye muscle area of 131 square centimetres. Months and under 18 months. First place goes to catalogue number 735, Blake Parker, is led by C.J. Bowen. That was calling our judge to comment.
This is the balance that I was talking about. You've got to really admire this calf. Look, you know, a bull that's 16 months of age and an eye muscle area of 131, but maintaining that softness, you know, he's got plenty of performance in this guy and still maintaining his structural integrity. You know, he could be a little bit stronger in the head, but in saying that, you know, there's a lot to love about this calf, and this is the sort of calf that I was hoping to see all day, and you know, he's an outstanding exhibit, so congratulations.
Dashing our champion and reserve junior champion bulls, Mr. Gary O'Keefe from Picture Hills, Devon, Taro. Now I turn to our judge, Chief Vice Comment on these champions.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Again, tremendous lineup from the I think it's a bull that is on the junior championship here today. He gets there for that great parade.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a strength in the next class, which is class 287. The lady months and under 20 months. So we're going to move straight on to the junior and reserve junior champion, Murray Gray Bull. So we'll just get the first place getters of those previous classes. judging our junior and reserve junior champion Murray Grey Bulls. We've got our first place getters of our previous classes ready before the judge. Catalogue number 725, 730, 733 and 735. Of our junior champion bull class, it's catalogue number 735. Gladen Parker, filled by P. J. Bowen. And our reserve junior champion is catalogue number 730. Glenview Napoleon, exhibited by the Smith Partnership. In addition to the Association Sash, trophies cost by Rojan and Red Gun Murray Grace, Sash is our champion, our junior champion, and our reserve junior champion, Judy King from Murray Grace. I'd like to call on our judge, Marty Rowlands, to comment on this championship class.
Yeah, look, ladies and gentlemen, it's been interesting, certainly very interesting to go to the Junior Bulls this morning. There's been such an array of difference in the cattle, and I'm fairly happy with the two that I've come up with in the leading line here today. Very easy decision for me to put the Grey Bull up on top. Look, he's an outstanding calf, and we talk about this balance of structure and balance of power and performance which we need. And we talk about, you know, the degree of meat and muscle while still maintaining, you know, that structural integrity. And, you know, he's an outstanding calf. If you look at those figures which are on his calf there and the sort of performance that we see in European cattle, but still maintaining that, that softness and smoothness through that front end. Granted, he's probably not as sire as the bull that I've got in reserve, but in saying that, there's enough there, and he's an outstanding calf. But just imagine the type of females this guy would breed. Look, I think he's well worthy of being a junior champion. Then we move over to the silver calf, and again, you look at the sire appeal in this guy, and he's certainly got it. And he's given a little bit away in weight for age, but in saying that, he hasn't given anything away in performance. You look at his fat covers. They're well on the way. Just gives a little bit of weight behind the shoulder, which has got him into reserve here today. If he was a little bit fuller in behind the shoulder, he probably would have given the Grey Bull a little bit more of a run for his money. But as far as we're concerned, his structural integrity and his sire appeal, softness and that balance that we're looking for, he's certainly a very, very good exhibit. So congratulations.
cover result in class 188, cow age 30 months and under 48 months. First place goes to catalogue number 428, Ashwood Cheddar Pink, exhibited by Malcolm Wood. Now, just the reserve is coming for the judging of the championship.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that's all cool. So, as long as it's
ladies and gentlemen, we're about to move on to our senior cow or heifer classes. We've had a number of scratchings for the first two classes, so that was class 288 and also 289 have both been scratched. All of the exhibits have been scratched. So we're going to move on to class 290, but we're just waiting on a couple of the exhibits to get ready for that. So we're just going to take about a 5 minute break.
Outstanding Power Heifer goes to kennel number 427, Little Manning Missing, exhibited by G.B. and B.R. Edwards. Presenting our Senior Champion and Reserve Senior Champion Cows is Bridget Edwards from Barrington Jocks.
Most successful show ever. It's very long.
Just going to talk to Brad and make sure he does it all again.
Well, just what these things are. I haven't seen anybody do it. I haven't
yet. I didn't
Well, they sell it. We're about to recommence judging in the Murray Grey Ring. As I mentioned before, the short break. Minus 288. There's two scratches there. 737, 738. Same for minus 289. So 739 and 740 have been scratched. So we're moving straight on to minus 290. Now 30 months and under 48 months. There's a catalogue hiccup. There's the first copy there without a number beside it. It's been scratched.
Now to judging the late Richard Arnold Power Toss Grand Champion Power Heifer. We have in the ring now catalogue
numbers 415, 416. We have four exhibits for this class to raise before the judge. Catalogue numbers 741, 743, 744 and 745. first place goes quite a long number, 741, before Lysandra, delivered by Robert Lee. Second place goes to catalogue number 745, Verena Park Charlotte, delivered by KJ Taylor and MJ Rose. Third place goes to catalogue number 743, Gagara Silver Jeanette, delivered by Kerry Leary. I'll get our judge going on this bus in a moment, but I'd also like to say that we have any other senior town passes that our first and second place getters also received the senior and reserve senior champion Cow or Heifer Award, and they will be presented by Barbara Hudson from Regala. I'll just call on our judge to comment on this bus.
Yeah, look, these cow and calf classes are always very, very interesting, and one thing I always look for in those females is the squareness and their ability to be durable within the breed. And the female that I've gone with up on top is, to be completely honest, a clear winner in the class. And I bang on about this neck expansion and femininity and capacity, and look at the style of ribbon this female, and she's outstanding now. And look at, there's no doubt about that she's got the capacity, and you know, there's just, you know, the calf's probably in a bit of a gangly stage, which is, you know, if we could swap the calf on the second cow and put it on the first cow, then I'd be really, really happy. But in saying that, she's doing an adequate job, and, you know, I just think she's an outstanding female. We've got to be very, very careful about the udders on these females, and, you know, we've got to make sure that they can last a very, very long time. And it does concern me just a wee bit with this cow. Just that rear quarter quadrant, and they're separated just a wee bit. But, you know, those connections on this udder is fine. And I think, you know, she's doing an adequate job, but, you know, she's an outstanding unit, there's no doubt about that. As with the female in second place, probably given a little bit away over that tail setting, and unfortunately, a little bit from hip to pin. But in saying that, you look at the length of body in this female, probably doesn't have the neck extension as the female that I've got in first place. But again, you've got to admire the length of body and the capacity in this female, coupled with the performance. She's an outstanding cow as well, and we talk about doing a job on a calf, and she's certainly doing a very good job at that. She's an outstanding cow, no doubt. Just a shame she's come against such a lovely complete package. And the female in third place, again, probably given a little bit away in frame score, as opposed to the two females on top. But when we look at capacity as well, she's just a little bit shy there. But look at the job she's doing on this calf, which has got her in third place here today. Again, a lovely, lovely, strong udder in this female. But she's an outstanding female as well. So congratulations to you. And take nothing away from the cow in fourth place. Look, neck extension in this female, the milk that's in this female, and that udder integrity as well. Probably giving a little bit away in structural correctness, but in saying that, four very, very lovely females and a long way to go in the breed. If we keep females like this, they're going to be in a good position as far as the breed's concerned as a whole. So congratulations to everyone.
on to the judging of the Grand Champion Carol or Heifer. Junior Champion and our Senior Champion who rode before the judge.
It's always very interesting when we come to this end of the competition and look, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for two very, very lovely females. And I've just been saying that while we applaud these guys, I just hope that you can see what I've done today as far as consistency. We look at these two females and there's not a lot between them. The style and the capacity, the power performance and the balance of that within, I think is just outstanding in these two females. Those that have seen me adjudicate on classes before well and truly know that I've got no issues, no cards, and the heifer's good enough that the heifer will beat the cow and calf. And you know, on this occasion, that's not going to happen. That cow and calf unit, I think, will represent the Murray Grey breed extremely well in the interbreed. And congratulations to name my grand champion female for cow and calf. I think the balance and performance in this female, she's an outstanding unit, the way she tracks around. Yeah, look, I've got a little bit of concern about that rear quadrant of those others, but in saying that, she's going to represent your breed. And I think she, as far as breed characteristics are concerned, yeah, we could have a little bit more condition on that potty, but we all know that sometimes that can be a little bit difficult in certainly in the growing stages of calves. But you know what, ladies and gentlemen, this is an outstanding unit, and it's a shame that I won't be going to the interbreed tomorrow, because she's certainly for catching my eye. She's an outstanding unit. Congratulations.
And if you're interested, he is the biggest bull on the range.
Thank you very much for those comments, Marty. So ladies and gentlemen, our Grand Champion, Carol Heifer, for the 2018 Royal Queensland Show in the Murray Grey Ring, is catalogue number 741. Before Lysandra, exhibited by Robert Lee. In addition to the association of SAS, there's a trophy sponsored by Bruna Park Murray Greys, a medallion sponsored by Murray Grey Beef Cattle Society, and also this Grand Champion receives the Elder Shield of Excellence sponsored by Limited. Is being presented today by Michael Smith from in Toowoomba. To Sash, our Grand Champion, we have Barbara Hudson from Fregala Park. We'll just take a short break while we get some photos of our Grand Champion, and then we'll move on to our Senior Bull Classes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have resulting class 591, all age 30 minutes and 4.
ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to our senior bulls in the Murray Grade. We're at class 291, bull 20 months and under 24 months. Well, ladies and gentlemen, just some information on the appearance that are parading for the judge in Murray Grey Ring. Catalogue number 746, weighs 904 kilograms, average daily gain of 1.37, fat measurements of 16 and 12, and an eye muscles area of 137 square centimetres. Catalogue number 747. Catalogue number 747, weighs 724 kilograms, average daily gain of 1.03, fat measurements of 15 and 9, eye muscle area of 111 square centimetres. Catalogue number 748, weighs 796 kilograms, average daily gain of 1.1, fat measurements of 9 and 6, eye muscle area of 118 square centimetres. Catalogue number 749, weighs 974 kilograms, average daily gain of 1.32, fat measurements of 12 and 10, and eye muscle area of 136 square centimetres. Catalogue number 750, weighs 866 kilograms, average daily gain of 1.17, fat measurements of 10 and 8, and an eye muscle area of 115 square centimetres. Second place goes to catalog number 746. Olympian Majestic, exhibited by TWJ18. Third place goes to catalog number 748. Hideaway Park, Commandos, exhibited by Wendy McDonald. I'd like to see all our judges to comment on this full class.
Yeah, look, a fairly easy decision for me to make in this class, and the bull that's up on top, look, and you have a look at the scale that's in this guy. The cleanness through the shoulder is probably what's got him there, and that little bit of extra neck extension. And people say, oh, well, you know, why do you want neck extension? And, you know, without that neck extension, you don't have length of body either. So length in the neck means length in the body, and certainly means the ability to breed that the replacement female should be at the requirement for that. And I think the durability in the bull, the length of the body, and that overall sire appeal, if you just lead him off, thanks, it's not the scale that we're looking for. He's not too big. He's saying that he's got it under the bull in second place, just through that shoulder set. If you have a look at the bull that's in second place, again, lovely length of body and outstanding softness in this guy, but still in front of him, he's just a little bit too coarse through that front for me. Again, you've got to admire the depth of body, the softness in that calf, and certainly the sound that's through the reproductive area is outstanding. Again, as with the bull that we've got in third place, another outstanding calf as far as length of body is concerned and strength of spine. Again, giving a little bit away in structural correctness, and we're going to see that as we move through these mature bulls, and we're going to be pulling them out a little bit just to make sure that we're going to have the longevity in those and certainly the durability. But if we can get a combination of both that length of body as well as the capacity, I think we're going to be in a very, very good shape and form for the Mojave Breed. So hopefully we can find the right bull, and that class winner before certainly is well on the track.
We have a single entry in this class, go on number 434.
Thanks very much for that, Marty. Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to class 292 for 24 months and under 30 months. Fat measurements of 14 and 10, and eye muscle area of 138 square centimetres. And catalogue number 752, which weighs 924 kilograms. Average daily gain of 1.13. Fat measurements of 10 and 10 millimetres, and an eye muscle area of 121 square centimetres.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have resulting class 192.
Oh, yeah, gentlemen, the results now of class 292 for 24 months and under 30 months. First place goes to catalog number 751, Verona Park, Richmond, driven by GG S.A. Taylor. Second place goes to catalog number 752, Hideaway Park, Ajax, driven by Wendy McDonald. For our judge to comment on the class.
Again, two different pools of research, but there's two different markets, two different scales, and certainly two different types. I've gone with the larger bull on the day, a little bit more size, capacity in him. Looking a little bit soft in those passings, but in saying that, I think he's a little more structurally integrity. Like, as we're talking about structure, we're talking about integrity, and we're talking about the ability to go out there and perhaps do the job a little bit more easily, I guess. And I could look, this guy doesn't have everything I'm looking for either, and he could probably be a lot better as far as structure is concerned, but I can deal with a little bit softer heel as opposed to a roll out the hook, and that's why this guy's in second. I think the hook structure of this guy could somewhat be improved. You've got to admire his softness and shape of body. But in saying that again, I've bought with the soft and yellow to both roll out and the front. But again, admirable for his softness. But again, when we're looking at structural integrity, I'm going to flip them that way. So congratulations for those guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to our senior and reverse senior champion bull classes, as we don't have any exhibits from class 293. So we have the winners of our first previous two senior bull classes separated for the judge. Catalog numbers 749 and 751. Champion Murray Grey Bull for the 2018 Royal Queensland Show. And our senior champion goes to catalog number 749, Kingsgrove Magnus, driven by KJ Taylor and MJ Rose. And our reserve senior champion goes to catalog number 746, Yolindi Majestic, driven by DW and JA Ming. In addition to receiving the association sash, our senior champion receives a trophy sponsored by Eureka Roman. We've got Rod Van from Eureka, who is going to be sashing our senior champion and also our reserve senior champion. I'd like to hand over to our judge to comment on this senior bull class.
Thank you, and I spoke about these two bulls in their class earlier, and look, I think there's a lot to like about this bull with the length of body, the stretch, the ability to track out is okay. He's good and clean through that shoulder, but most of all, it's his durability and his ability to sit a number of markets, and certainly that's got him here on the day. And we spoke about this guy in reserve as well. So you've got to admire the depth of body, the shape of rib in this guy, and certainly his overall ability. He's certainly admirable, and it's just it's his overall flexibility within a size role, which is played over the ball, the other. We spoke about this before, and I think his overall structural integrity of the castle. Two very good bulls, and congratulations.
So we're just doing some photos here, and then we'll move on to our Grand Champion Bull, which will be our Junior Champion and our Senior Champion. Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to our Grand Champion Bull. We've got our Junior Champion, which is catalog number 735, and our Senior Champion, catalog number 749, which is the Racing Quarter Grand.
What was it? What did you do on that? Senior Camp.
Very interesting, these two cars, and well, I say cars in the sense that they're both relatively young in the working life, and but they're two pretty good exhibits, really, and I've just gone down and had a look at their stand data and re-evaluated things, and you know, we spoke at length on both of these bulls, and you know, have a look at the scan data on that young calf, and we're talking pretty good scan data as far as growth for age is concerned. But if we can produce bulls like that in the Murray Grey breed and have that sort of performance rivaling the European breeds, I think it's pretty outstanding to have that sort of calf and that sort of performance in a calf. Yeah, we said that he probably doesn't have the same sire head that the senior bull has got, but in saying that, I think there's a lot to love about that junior bull, and today he's my grand champion. So congratulations to him, and take nothing away from that centre ball. He's certainly mobile enough, and it's the overall hook structure of this ball that I've placed him up on top today. And look, he's going to do the breed well, and I just hope that the interbreed judge admires him as much as I do, and certainly the performance as far as the low grade breed is concerned. And we ought to be very, very proud of the durability in this calf, and again, that neck extension and that cleanness through the shoulder and in behind the shoulder. Overall performance and length of body, I think, you know, he's got a lot to offer the breed, and congratulations to the exhibitor.
Thanks very much for those comments, Marty. So, ladies and gentlemen, our grand champion, Murray Grey Bull, for the 2018 Royal Queensland Show is catalogue number 735. Clayton Parker, by PJ Bowen. In addition to the association staff, our grand champion receives the Elders Shield of Excellence, sponsored by Elders Limited. Presented by Michael Smith from Albert Studstock in Toowoomba. Grand Champion also receives a medallion sponsored by the Murray Grey Beef Paddle Society and a trophy sponsored by the Murray Grey Beef Paddle Chris Anderson.
Thank you.
two pretty cool exhibits for the Murray Grey breed, and ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for two outstanding exhibits.
You know,
as a breeder of European cattle, and I see the sort of performance, it really does make you stand back and wonder, well, you know, it reinforces that I'm doing the right thing within our breeding operation. And, you know, we don't have cattle that are dissimilar to both these styles, and you just got to love the way they're both put together. And as we all say, you know, we could have a little bit more sappiness in that potty, but in saying that, you know, she's back in calf, and you know, there's nothing wrong with that calf. But, you know, at the end of the day, she's an outstanding cow, she's an outstanding individual, and she's given us some progeny, and that's what we do this piece for. And you know, she's structurally sound. You know, she walks particularly well. She cleans through that shoulder. Lovely neck extension, and there's a lot to love about her. In saying that, the bull has got plenty of neck extension in him. He's good and clean through the shoulder, and he's impeccable on those feet and legs. And that's what's really, really important, is that we maintain this structural integrity right through our herds. And if he can have just one degree of, or one fraction of an impact on a herd, then, you know, the cattle that I've seen here today, he's got a lot to offer every breeder. And in saying that, if he was mine, you know, I'd be hoping that people would take advantage of that. He's just an outstanding individual, and congratulations today, my supreme exhibit for bull. You know, we talk about how cattle can have an influence on any one breed, and you know, there's enough within our individual herds to pull him through as far as sire appeal is. But you know, you've got to look at this calf. He's only 16 months of age. By the time he matures into that head, you know, he's going to be an outstanding individual. And take nothing away from that cow. I really do love that cow. But we've got an outstanding pair for the interbreed this afternoon. And you know, you ought to be very, very proud of the quality of the cattle that we've seen here today. And we're going to move on to the group shortly, which is sort of the pointy end of their business. And once we see these groups, you can see what breeders are actually doing. And I'm a person that stands here today that looks at my personal preference, and that's what's really difficult when you get asked to judge in a show like this, and you've got such a diverse range of types of cattle. And I look for what I basically do in my program, and try and have a quick stance on how I do that in the Murray Grey breed. And you know, if I had a paddock full of these cows, I'd be bloody well happy. And she's an awesome individual. The bull's an awesome individual, and congratulations to the breed as a whole.
Thank you very much for that, Marty. So, ladies and gentlemen, just reconfirming that our supreme exhibit this year, the 2018 Royal Queensland Show, is catalogue number 735. The junior bull, Clayton Parker, moved by PJ Bowen. And our green exhibit receives the John F. Sturgeon Medal, which today is presented by Joyce Verdi. Brooke Parsons and Murray Grey Ring.
Presenting our
class 295 is a pair of bulls, 8 months and under 24 months. Bred New South Wales by the
Shorthorn Society. You are judging here on Saturday. And now I can invite our judge to pass his comment on this.
It is, isn't it? It's nice. Okay, now I'll see you after. Okay, bye.
Gentlemen, the results are now of class 294, pair of bulls. First place goes to cattle number 754, the mare interviewed by DWJ18. Second place goes to cattle number 753, a pair of bulls interviewed by Wendy McDonald. Will our judge to comment on the first pair of bred classes?
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, a very easy class to judge, and it's just the uniformity in the group that I've got in first place is somewhat superior to the group in second. Look at the length of body and the softness within the two individuals in first place, and that has outshone on the group in second on the day. The length of body, the style and softness of that first group is just somewhat more desirable in my eye.
Great, thanks very much, Mark. Three animals, both sexes to be represented, bred and owned by the exhibitor. We have quite a few entries for this class, so we'll just get everyone together and then we'll have the exhibitors parading for our judges.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a result in class 361, care for age 16 months and under. Dunbeaton Clementine, exhibited by Dunbeaton Cole Shorthorns, and our reserve junior champion, Pepo Cabot.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the results of our class 295. First place goes Catalog number 756. Group of Three Animals, exhibited by KJ Carling and MK Rose. Second place goes to catalog number 761, group exhibited by the Smith Partnership. And third place goes to catalog number 760, group exhibited by the Smith Partnership. Our judge will comment on the group.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's very easy to come up with an outstanding individual, but it's quite a credit when you come up with an outstanding individual. To bring three animals out of similar quality, similar style, and you can certainly see the breeding pattern within the animals that I've got in first place. Again, we spoke about this today, and we talk about it, and I'll bang on it every day of the week, and it's length of body, and it's style of cattle, and, you know, length ways. At the end of the day, it's cents per kilo we're paid on, and we've got to maintain a little bit of growth in these cattle, and certainly the performance. We know that we're going to have the eating quality. There's no doubt about that within this breed. And we've just got to, if we can maintain a little bit of that frame, then we're going to be rewarded highly, and certainly you'll start turning some heads, and, you know, if we can get a few more Queenslanders, we'll see the qualities of the Murray Grey breed, and moving these type of cattle into the central environments, and, you know, we could be on the winner here, and we can have the scale of these sort of cattle, and we can start producing some beef and that's what we're all about. You have a look at the scale in this group, you have a look at the length of body, and the uniformity of type is very consistent throughout the group. Not dissimilar to the second group, and we're looking at spots again, the style and capacity of these guys in second place. Very, very similar type females, and led out by a very, very strong calf. And, you know, I said this just at the beginning, if we have a very solid individual, then you need to maintain that, you need to come up with a very, very solid group in these classes. But, you know, we've got an outstanding individual in the third group. Probably let down a little bit as far as uniformity is concerned. Look at the style of the cow, the style of the bull that follows her. We had a bull that was a little bit more scaly in size, probably a little bit more neck extension, probably would have been a little more competitive, but in saying that, it's a very, very handy group, and congratulations to all the exhibitors in this class.
Thanks for that, buddy. Ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to the last of our classes, which is class 296. Allow a little bit of time for our exhibitors to get this judge now is class 296, Murray Grey Progeny Stakes Group. three animals, both sexes to be represented. All the progeny of one stock, but not necessarily owned by the exhibitor.
Did this win?
Ben Whelan and Tammy Whelan. And now I can invite our judge, two passes come in on this class. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll now move on to the bull section. I think two bulls have really offer a lot to the industry. When we look at the data on the cards of these bulls, bulls with some menace there, made a weight ratio, but still with the ability to run and see if they come from this age. I mean, they're good to the forefront for this age. They're only young babies, obviously they've got to have time to develop into themselves. But I think that the bull that wins this class, he gets there on his overall structure and that requirements for that front end. The bull that just naturally flies along his head up through the air, tremendous strength of a muzzle on this bull. The bull that will sorry out, I'd like to streak the top of the amount of muscle in for that weight, and the bull that just balances really well. The bull in second place again, the tremendous amount of air made for that weight, 125 square centimetres for 610 kilos. The bull with tremendous high quarter. To win that, I think he still is floats around the ring with a degree of no drama whatsoever. I think probably not quite the degree of climbing through that front end, but that amount of power on top, we're not going to get a real feminine front of bull, but the bull just doesn't quite naturally float as well for that front end as bull with the class, but a bull with the green spurs in the mountain carcass, which shows for a bull that they
have to keep. Thank you, Roger. And presenting the winners in their class is Mr. David Spencer from the Spencer Family School of Hollywood. We move now on to our second junior book class, class 363, bull age 16 months and up to 20 months. Single entry in this class, ladies and gentlemen, catalog number 1202.
First place goes to catalogue number 762, the group Hotwood Meatloaf, Smith Partnership. Second place goes to catalogue number 763, the group Mike Long Advanced, M2, by Robert Lee. And third place goes to catalogue number 764, Steel Road Cowboy, exhibited by Wendy Donnelly. I'd like to call on our judge, Marty Rowland, to make comment on this class and also just conclude, I suppose, that this is the last class of Murray Grays for this year.
Yeah, the group that I've got up on top, just an outstanding young group, and you can see the style, the quality, and it really got anxious at the quality and the style of these three of the people. Even though there's a slight degree difference in colour type, that doesn't stop the degree of the style, the length of body, which is maintained right throughout this group. The structural integrity is very, very good. Led by a very, very good bull, and followed by two very, very good heifers. An outstanding little package, those three. If the heifer had stayed in this group at the end, probably would have picked these guys. And we've spoken about this cow at length today, and the heifer that follows her, two outstanding individuals, and probably would have been a more uniform group if the heifer had stayed there, but probably a different cross on the set of things. But nevertheless, three very good individuals. As with the group in third place, you can certainly see the Cyrus Huxley brand into these three. Very similar in type and style, and unfortunately just on the day, probably not my style. And that's the beauty of judging, is that Well, it's a beauty in my eyes, which is my style on the day, and unfortunately for some exhibitors, you can certainly see the uniformity in that group, but unfortunately just not the style on the day that I was looking for. Somewhat difficult when you're doing a job like this, and people certainly have a great following or a great uniformity, and it's very disappointing, and it happened to me yesterday. Sometimes it's just not what the judge is looking for. But so long as you're happy with what your exhibits look like today, and remember it's just my decision on the day, but there's dozens of other people on the outside of the ring which may have put your cattle up today, and just remember that it's not just so much what I think, but it's what those on the outside of the ring think on the day. And one thing you can be sure of is people misrepresent their cattle very, very well today, and you should all be very, very proud as a breed to think that you've got such diversity, and diversity to fit a lot of different markets. And I thank you again for the invitation. Certainly thank the Murray Grey Breed for the invitation and entrusting my thoughts on the day for today, and thank you to the RNA for inviting me along. I really do appreciate it, and it's a great honour to be here. So thank you again, and I'll make my way up to the sheds, and if I make it from one end to the other, I've probably done well, but please don't chase me with a bat. I'd like to make it through and see all the exhibitors, and we can have a one-on-one there, and if you've got any further questions, I'm quite happy to answer those. So congratulations again to all the exhibitors today, and thank you so much to you.
Thanks very much for that, Marty. And ladies and gentlemen, that wraps up the judging for the Murray Greys this year. I'd like to thank our judge
Bull that won the baby class here, ladies and gentlemen. A bull that tremendous amount of weight that bear went through his weight, 110 to 540 kilos.
Just one more little announcement.
Still retaining softness in skin and ability to put a even fat cover. A bull I'd probably like to just tidy up through that over region, but I think bull with really natural talents and its presence. The bull that Tom has given won that second junior class. Again, a bull that tremendous amount of weight, probably not quite as clean through that front end as it is our baby class. And for that reason, in 2018, I'm going to go through a baby class.
Thank you.